Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 27th of January. Security tightened in Indian capital and its borders after farmers' tractor rally violence. US President Biden extends commitment to NATO counter-terrorism efforts in Afghanistan. And Nepal kicks off coronavirus inoculations with Indian vaccine. And now for all the details. Security was beefed up in Indian capital New Delhi on Wednesday following violent clashes between protesting farmers and police. A protest parade of tractors around the city's fringes to coincide with Tuesday's Republic Day celebrations turned to chaos when some farmers diverged from agreed routes, breaking through barricades and clashing with police, who used tear gas and baton to try to restrain them.
Security was tightened in New Delhi and its borders on Wednesday after a massive farmers' tractor rally to coincide with Tuesday's Republic Day celebrations witnessed violent clashes between protesting farmers and police. Thousands of farmers protesting against new farm laws that liberalize agriculture sector had stormed into the historic Red Fort complex in the Indian capital after tearing down barricades and driving tractors through roadblocks. Police fired tear gas in an unsuccessful bid to force the protesters back. One protester was killed, a witness said, and Delhi police said 86 officers had been injured across the city. Police said they had registered 22 cases against protesters on charges including rioting, damage to public property and assault on public servants. Meanwhile, farmer leaders on Wednesday condemned the violence and breaching into the Red Fort by a section of protesters.
लाल किले पे जो भी हिंसक घटनाएं हुई, लाल किले पे जो भी झंडा फहराया गया, हम उसकी सपोर्ट नहीं करते, हम उसकी निंदा करते, वो हमारे कार्यक्रम नहीं था। हमें क्योंकि देश का वो एक जगह एक सिंबल है, तो वहाँ ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए, और हमें पूरे जो देश के सामने हुआ, उसको एक तरह से पूरे आंदोलन को हमें शर्मिंदा किया।
Angered by the new laws that they believe benefit only big corporations, tens of thousands of farmers have been camped on the outskirts of the New Delhi for 2 months. Several rounds of talks between farmer unions and the government have failed to resolve the impasse, as farmer leaders have rejected the government's offer to delay the laws for 18 months, making a push for repeal instead.
India has vaccinated 2 million health workers in less than 2 weeks and recorded 12,689 new coronavirus positive cases in the past 24 hours, the lowest daily spike the country reported after 8 months. Meanwhile, Indian Council of Medical Research on Wednesday said that Bharat Biotech's Covaxin vaccine has been proved to work against new UK COVID strain. Covaxin has been jointly developed by Bharat Biotech and the ICMR. India, that kicked off the world's largest vaccination drive on January 16, has breached the 2 million mark in vaccination of healthcare workers. As per the Health Ministry report on Wednesday, a cumulative 2,029,424 vaccinations have been completed so far through 36,572 sessions. This comes as India reported 9,102 new cases of the novel coronavirus in the last 24 hours, the lowest daily spike the country reported after 8 months. With the fresh COVID-19 cases, the tally has now mounted to 10,676,838. Meanwhile, Indian Council of Medical Research ICMR on Wednesday said that Bharat Biotech's Covaxin vaccine has been proved to work against new UK COVID strain. Covaxin, which has been jointly developed by Bharat Biotech and the ICMR, had received the restricted emergency use authorization by the apex drug regulator in India along with Oxford University AstraZeneca's Covishield being manufactured by the Serum Institute of India. India's Health Minister Harshvardhan, earlier speaking at the WHO Executive Board meeting on Tuesday, said the world is on the verge of defeating the coronavirus pandemic.
Allow me to thank the member nations that despite the wide disparity in their epidemiological trends, we are on the verge of defeating the pandemic by adopting a preemptive, proactive and collaborative strategy.
India, the world's largest vaccine producer, has donated millions of doses of vaccine being produced in the country to neighboring South Asian nations. In news from Afghanistan, United States President Joe Biden has reaffirmed U.S. commitment to the NATO, setting the stage for renewed transatlantic ties. The NATO said that its Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg and Biden talked over phone and stressed the need to maintain the momentum for increased defense spending and also discuss counter-terrorism efforts in Afghanistan.
U.S. President Joe Biden, in a call with NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg on Tuesday night, reaffirmed the U.S. commitment to the alliance's collective defense and discussed countering international terrorism, including in Afghanistan and Iraq. The White House, in a statement, said President Biden told Stoltenberg that the United States was committed to collective defense under the North Atlantic Treaty Organization and underscored his commitment to strengthening transatlantic security. Stoltenberg, who has invited Biden to Brussels for a NATO summit on an unconfirmed date this year, said the two had stressed the need to maintain the momentum for increased defense spending. Earlier this month, the number of U.S. troops in Afghanistan went down to 2,500, the lowest level of American forces there since 2001. But violence levels in Afghanistan have surged, hastening international calls for a ceasefire between the Afghan government and the Taliban. The Biden administration is expected to announce its stance on the Afghan peace process and the presence of NATO forces in Afghanistan at the ministerial meeting of the alliance next month.
Moving on, all line department employees in illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a press conference to raise the demand of equal pay and allowances at par with other government employees in Pakistan. Highlighting exploitation, they blame the authorities have kept on delaying the process for the past several years.
All-line Department Employees Association in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a press conference highlighting discrimination in salaries granted to them. The association leader said the employees have been long demanding equal pay, time scale, hiring and utility allowances at par with their counterparts in Pakistan, from which they have been deprived. They want to hold massive protests against the government if their demands are not met.
Our main maksad, sabse pehli jo baat hai, wo tankhaon ke andar jo discrimination paya jata hai, to hum hukumat e waqt se yahan ki provincial government se ye mutalba karte hain, अपील करते हैं कि खुदारा मतलब इस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन को खत्म करें और सारे सारों की तनख्वाहें जो हैं बलिहाज ओहदा सिकेल उन सारों की तनख्वाहें जो हैं वो इक्वल कर दें.
Locals and government workers in Gilgit-Baltistan have to often hit the streets to demand even their basic rights. There are over 50,000 line department employees across Gilgit-Baltistan. They said it is indeed appalling that people who have served for several years in the government have still not been given equal rights.
In news from Nepal, Nepal government on Wednesday started the first phase of a vaccination campaign against COVID-19 as Nepali Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli inaugurated the campaign through a virtual event. The vaccination process began from 120 vaccine centers across the country and targeted health workers, sanitation workers, and elderly people living in care homes, among others.
Rolling out 1 million vaccines produced by Serum Institute of India and provided by Indian government in grant assistance, Nepal on Wednesday started its inoculation drive against COVID-19. Frontline workers such as doctors, nurses, hospital cleaners, members of security forces are the first to get the jab in the Himalayan nation. Nepal received a batch of 1 million doses of COVID Shield vaccine from India on grant assistance last week, which also would be administered to the elderly as well as those suffering from chronic diseases with the second phase of COVID-19 vaccination. Meanwhile, Nepal's caretaker Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli has expressed his gratitude towards India for extending 1 million dosages of COVID Shield within a week of its rollout in India.
Hamile chhitai nai es khop ko shuruaat garne mauka payau. Eska nimti hamro chimeki mitra rashtra Bharat sarkar, Bharat ka janta र खास गरी महामहिम प्रधानमन्त्री नरेन्द्र मोदीजी प्रति म धन्यवाद भन्न चाहन्छु कि उहाँहरूले आफूले सुरु गरेको हप्ता दिनभित्रै जसो हामीले सुरु गर्न सक्ने गरी हामीलाई 10 लाख डोज उपलब्ध गराउनु भएको छ त्यही पनि डोनेसनमा.
From being the first nation in South Asia to confirm the infection of coronavirus back in 2020, Nepal till date has recorded a total of 270,092 cases of COVID-19 with 217 deaths and 264,823 recoveries.
More news from Nepal. 10 Nepali climbers who set a record by successfully scaling K2, the world's second highest mountain in the winter season, received a hero's welcome as they arrived back in country on Tuesday. The mountain that straddles the Pakistan-China border was first climbed in 1954, but had never been summited in the winter. A team of Nepali climbers that made the first winter summit of K2, the world's second tallest peak, arrived back in the country to a hero's welcome on Tuesday from crowds of well-wishers. Fans and families placed colorful Buddhist prayer scarves on the climbers' shoulders on their arrival at Nepal's only international airport in Kathmandu. The 10 men who climbed the 8,611-meter, that is 28,251-foot, K2 peak on January 16 attributed their success to team spirit and a resolve to raise their country's pride. Climbing leader Nirmal Purja said the K2 ascent was a huge achievement for all climbers to celebrate.
As a team, we feel really proud, we feel really honored, and I think we send a really clear message to the world. If you unite, nothing is impossible. So everybody's happy here, and thank you so much for all the press and all our friends for being here today this morning. Thank you so much.
Presenting letters of appreciation to the climbers in Baluwathar, Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli announced they will be felicitated with medals in the future. The mountain that straddles the Pakistan-China border was first climbed in 1954, but had never been summited in the winter.
Sri Lanka has thought of conducting a countrywide elephant census this year to determine the exact number of elephants in the country. This comes as the island nation last year recorded the highest annual elephant deaths and second highest human deaths in the world due to the human-elephant conflict.
Sri Lanka's Department of Wildlife Conservation will conduct a countrywide elephant census this year to determine the exact number of elephants in the country, local media reported earlier this week. Secretary to the Ministry of Wildlife Conservation, Bandula Harish Chandra, said an elephant census was last conducted in 2011 and it was estimated that Sri Lanka had 5,179 elephants. This comes as Sri Lanka last year recorded the highest annual elephant deaths and second highest human deaths in the world due to the human-elephant conflict, according to Sri Lanka's Committee on Public Accounts, or COPA. According to COPA Chairman Tistavitharana, while the average number of human deaths due to the human-elephant conflict is 85 per year, 122 people had died during the past year. Killing wild elephants in Sri Lanka is a criminal offense, but there have been regular reports of angry villagers poisoning or shooting them.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.